If you're thinking of building a website in 2023 but haven't yet because you worry it's too hard or too expensive, or you just don't know where to start, you've come to the right place. The good news is there are so many all-in-one platforms that allow anyone with zero coding or design experience to create a functional and stunning professional website. But there are some things you need to know before getting started, which is why in today's video, I've put together the ultimate guide for beginners. We'll cover how websites actually work in the simplest terms, how to get clear on the purpose of your site, plus 10 different types of profitable websites, and how to choose which one is actually right for you. So let's go. Okay, for starters, you might be wondering, why have a website? Well, having a website for your business or personal brand can offer so many benefits. First, it'll increase your visibility and your credibility. A website can help you reach a wide audience and establish a professional online presence that can build trust and credibility with potential customers or clients. Also, having a website allows for better customer engagement and communication because your site can provide a platform for engaging with customers or followers through features such as blogs, forums, or even direct messaging. And finally, you'll have greater control over your online presence. The truth is, we're living in the era of internet, and having a presence is important whether you like it or not. A personal website gives you more control over the content and messaging associated with your brand, allowing you to showcase your strengths and differentiate yourself from competitors. Okay, in order to figure out what kind of website you want to make, what builder you want to use, and whether it's going to cost money or not, let's start with answering the most simple yet important question. What actually is a website? I know, this sounds basic, but technology has advanced a lot in the last decade or so the terminology can actually get confusing. There are three main components of a website, and we can compare it to a brick and mortar business to understand it better. First, we have the domain. This is the URL you type into a browser that directs you to a website. This is your address on the web. So just like you'd have a business address at your brick and mortar shop, the URL, the domain, is your business's address on the interwebs. The second component is the website itself. Now, the website is essentially a collection of files that hold all of the components that make up your site, from pages to design, things like that. This is like the actual building that your store is in. And finally, we have the host, aka the online server space where these files are actually stored. So this would be like the land that your business building sits on. Does that make sense? So what happens when you visit a website is you type the domain into a browser, it goes to the server or host, aka where the website resides, and says, yo, show me this website. The host then finds the website and spits it back out into what you see on your browser. So it's kind of like when you type Nordstrom's address into Google Maps, it finds that land, directs you to it, and when you get there, you can enter the store, which contains all of the clothing, or web pages, that you're free to navigate through. Now, why is this important? Well, in the past, most website builders did not include hosting or domains. So you had to build your website and then separately find a host and separately find a domain. But these three things would come from separate companies and cost various amounts of money. It was very complicated, honestly, very hard to choose and really expensive. Nowadays though, most website builders have created an all-in-one solution that includes web hosting, domain registration, and a built-in editor for one monthly fee. Thank goodness. But I still do believe it's important to understand all of that terminology in case you ever stumble across a builder that requires you to pay for hosting or other things. Now you'll know what that means. Now, you might be wondering, do websites always cost money? What I want people to realize is that free website builders do exist. It is possible to have a fully functioning website out there on the internet without having spent a dime. This is really nice because you can play around with designs and see what your website could really look like without any commitment or payment yet. That definitely wasn't always the case, okay? When I first made a website back in like 2015, I paid all this money for hosting and templates, and then I ended up not even wanting to have a website. I don't even know why I wanted one in the first place. But yes, now you can make a fully functioning website for free and only upgrade to a paid plan when you need to add premium functions like selling products, booking appointments, things like that. You guys already know that Wix is my preferred website building platform. I make all of my sites on Wix pretty much exclusively. With Wix, it's quick and easy and has hundreds of stunning templates to choose from, so I'll leave a link down below if you want to check it out. I've also made free websites on Canva, and you can check out the tutorial right here. But I want to clear something up really quick. I get tons of comments on my Wix website tutorials saying, it's not free, like I got charged. But like I said, this is only the case if the website you've designed includes premium or add-on features. Certain features do require a paid plan in order to set the website live, so make sure you check which features require a paid plan before you start building it. That way you don't put all this time and effort into building your website only to find out at the very end that it's not free. Okay. Also, if you do go with a paid plan, Wix offers a 14-day free trial before you get charged. So that's another way to test out some of the paid features before committing. If you want, I'll make a video going more in depth on this topic, including which website builders cost what and what's included on each, so you can really figure out what's right for you. But for now, it'll help so much to figure out what kind of website you need and with what capabilities before you start building. Which leads me to number three. Let's get clear on the purpose of your website, okay? Before you begin, you should ask yourself, what is it there to do? We know why having a presence in multiple places online is important. So now if someone stumbles across your site, what do you want to happen next? Do you want it to drive traffic out to your social media pages? Or do you want to use social media to drive traffic to your website? It'll help to ask yourself, what is everything you do online ultimately funneling to? So what result do you want? Product sales? Do you want followers, views, friends? For example, imagine someone has the primary goal of selling products. They would obviously set up an online store website, and the goal would be sales on the site, right? So they might use social media to both create awareness around their products and ultimately direct people to their website where they can buy the product. Or it might be the other way around. Maybe someone is a successful YouTuber and they make their income from both sponsorships and ad revenue from views on their YouTube channel. So they may have a website to display work examples and allow brands to get in touch. But the ultimate goal would be to drive traffic out to their YouTube channel, right? Since that's making majority of their income. Or maybe you don't have one clear end result in mind, and that works too, okay? For me, I make revenue in various places online, from YouTube videos to consulting calls, and I also sell merch. So I pretty much want my website to be like an all-encompassing Adrian hub that helps people easily understand all of these aspects of what I do and then navigate to where they need to go. So as you can see, having an idea of the purpose of your site will help dictate what kind of website you want to create, and therefore which builder or platform is best and what capabilities and functions you need the site to be able to perform. Now, what kind of website should you create? Using what you decided above, you can now choose what type of website will work best for you. The beauty of a website is it doesn't have to stay one thing forever. You can incorporate multiple of these functions on one website, for example, an online store that also has a blog. But as a beginner, it's beneficial to start with just one in mind so that you don't get overwhelmed. So here are the most common types of websites. These can all be profitable on their own, but can also be supplemental to whatever business you already have, and they're very suitable for beginners. Let me know, by the way, if you'd want me to make a separate video going more in depth on these, because there's so much you can do with each. The first kind of website is a blog. People use blogs to connect with others, to showcase their writing chops, or share their expertise on something. While blogging initially began as a way for individuals to share their ideas online, 86% of businesses now employ blogging as part of their content marketing strategy. Some even figure out how to monetize a blog and make writing their full-time job. Literally a dream. The next kind of website is an e-learning or kind of education hub. If you're an expert in a particular area, consider creating an e-learning website so that you can teach others about it. This type of website can include a series of videos on any topic of your choice. It can have courses, webinars, workshops, PDF downloads, and people often draw in viewers or paid customers by first offering some videos for free. I know a lot of people that offer like free downloads, wallpapers, things like that. Creating these kinds of tutorials and workshops can be a really effective way to make money online. And you don't even need to be that much ahead in terms of what you know. As long as you're one step ahead, you can be a great teacher and help others who are beginners at whatever you do. The next kind of store is an e-commerce store, AKA just an online store. So here you can sell physical goods, digital goods. You can do drop shipping from third-party retailers. You can link up with a print-on-demand company, design clothing, really anything. And starting an online store can actually be a relatively painless process if you have the right tools at your disposal, which many website builders do nowadays. No coding necessary, which is awesome. The next kind of website is a portfolio website. This can serve as a resume or a portfolio. You can showcase your visual work, particularly if you're an artist or a photographer or a fashion model or designer or pretty much anything. A beautiful online portfolio will help you gain professional opportunities, and it can even help you develop a fan base. The beauty of a website is it doesn't have to stay one thing forever, so maybe people see your portfolio and want to learn how to become an expert in your field, which you can then incorporate links to tutorials, courses, products, so much more. The next kind of website is a resume website. So this is similar to a portfolio website as it allows you to put your experience and expertise on display. But think of this one as a little less visual and more of an in-depth business card. This type of website is valuable for professionals in pretty much every field. It boosts your credibility among potential clients, business partners, and employers, and people can really just find all information about you right there. The next type of site is a nonprofit website, and a nonprofit website can help you raise awareness about a cause, attract volunteers, and gather donations. Creating a nonprofit website is doable for any organization in the field, even those that lack a professional web designer. Once again, super easy to make. Next, we have the event website. So a promotional event website will help you provide guests with all the information they need for an upcoming event, whether it's a wedding or really anything. And if you actually want to sell tickets from your website, many builders have that capability too. The next kind of website is a business website. A lot of the types of websites mentioned above are businesses in and of themselves, so this applies to those as well as any business at all for that matter. Whether you work at a film studio or a marketing agency or a clothing store, having a website that mirrors the look and feel of your business is important. You want people to be able to find you on the web and really kind of connect and understand what it is that you're doing. This is also a great idea for professionals looking to expand their reach online or even find new customers or clients. For example, my mom is a psychologist and she's always gotten her clients through word of mouth and just through her reputation she's built over the last 30 years. But now that the internet is a thing, she may want to have a website so that people searching for therapy in her area could actually find her services and get to know her better. I'd say it definitely builds credibility with prospective clients, and if she wanted to take it up a notch, she could even add a booking system or scheduling software that enables customers to easily reserve an appointment. I love that. And lastly, we have a personal website. This is the website for anyone for any purpose. You can use your site to tell your personal story or showcase your latest projects or simply build your presence on the web, really whatever you want. Okay, I know we just covered a lot, which is why there will be a part two coming very soon, actually. In part two, we'll cover choosing a website builder, choosing and finding a domain, and how to actually brand and design your site, including some 2023 design trends that you should definitely look out for. So subscribe if you haven't already, and check out these website building tutorials if you'd like, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.